Hey guys, it's Nikita here. Welcome to my channel Creativity is with Nikita. So today I'm going to share with you how to make this very beautiful, cute, quilled Krishna or Gopal painting. So without any further ado, let's jump into the video. Things which you're going to require today are some colorful 45mm quilling strips. I'm using camel watercolor cakes, 18 shades, pair of scissors, quilling tool, pair of tweezers, compass, pencil, paintbrush, black pen, an eraser, Fevicol MR, glue, this is liquid glue, then a ruler, a clip, and also the A3 size paper. So first I have drawn using my pencil on a white sheet of paper which measures 39 by 29 centimeter. Then I'm using white poster color as my primer or base color and my thick 8 brush so that the colors blend easily. Then wash your brush completely, and I'm going to use this cerulean blue and white color from the Artist Watercolor Cakes box. Just mix it a while and then start coloring from Krishna's hand. Wash your brush again and then just blend it the harsh lines. If you like my videos and creative works, then do not forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the bell icon for latest updates. If you have any doubts and suggestions, then do comment down in the comment section below. It would be very helpful. Now for shading purposes or shading areas, I'm using the same cerulean blue color and a little bit of white with my thinner brush. This is size number 2, and I'm just blending a little bit like so, and you can see I'm applying little by little and just blending each and every harsh lines. Now for the jewelry areas, I'm using chrome yellow from the poster color box, and for shading purposes I'll be using ochre yellow for the jewelries and some ornamental purposes. Then I'm using sap green and leaf green for the pot, and then at last, after coloring everything, I'm just bordering or outlining the features of Lord Krishna or Gopal using my black pen. I'm not going to outline the features of his mouth because I want to show the curd around his mouth, so I will be highlighting the features using pencil. Now using a paper cutter or pair of scissors, you can cut the excess white sheet outlining the figure like so. Now I will take 9 cm as a radius of a circle, and using my compass I will draw a circle on a yellow chart paper and just outline the circle and cut out the yellow chart paper or the yellow circle. Then we'll take an A3 sheet of white paper, and then we'll stick this yellow circle using my Fevicol MR glue, and then the Lord Krishna cut out over it. I will also paste the curd using my glue over the A3 sheet. After pasting every cutouts, my painting will look like this. Now start with the quilling procedure. I will take my quilling tool and 1/6 strip of red color and then attach 1/4 strip of yellow color and make a tight coil like so. So we will need 50 tight coils like so to decorate the jewelry of Lord Krishna. Now I will start to make a tight coil using 1/2 strip of yellow color and 1/4 strip of sap green or any deep green. You can also follow me on my Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, Dailymotion and blog, that is Creativities with Nikita. All of the links will be down in the description box below. Now I will take 1/2 strip of sap green color and make a loose coil like so and attach 1/4 or 1/6 strip of yellow color to it and attach the last end of the yellow strip to the loose coil and pinch it from one side to make a teardrop shape. Now let's start to make a swirl. So I'm using 1/4 strips of yellow color and join or attach them at one end using my liquid Fevicol MR glue, and on both the ends I will join deep blue. Now with the help of tweezers I will just quill it from the attached end. After quilling, release your tweezers slightly and cut the excess using your scissors and then pull each and every strips towards yourself from blue from inside to the outside. When you are satisfied, measure the swirl and just attach the ends using glue. Now I will take 1/4 strip of red color and 1/4 strip of blue color and just make a tight teardrop shape. You can also use pink or any dark shade, a complementary shade, instead of these colors. Now I will make tight coil using 1/6 strip of yellow color and 1/6 strip of green color. There will be two separate tight coils. Now we will attach the shapes to our painting. So this is the teardrop shape we will attach to the mouth of the pot, and then this is the green tight coil, and then we will attach these teardrop shapes. So these are the swirls we will attach over here. Before that we will attach green tight coils also over here, and then we will attach the swirls in the form of heart shape. You have to hold them for a while to get attached because they tend to loose up or move from their place. So this teardrop shape is made with half strip of yellow, half strip of green, and then 1/4 strip of orange color. Then I will add a teardrop shape of pink and blue over here. I've also made teardrop shape using 1/4 strip of blue and 1/6 strip of yellow color, and in the middle I have placed 1/4 strip of yellow color tight coil. Then we'll need 1/4 strip of yellow color and make a loose coil like so using your quilling tool and freehand. And then I will attach the loose coil and just make and pinch a Malaysian flower petal, and then we'll add the half strip of red color to surround the pinched yellow Malaysian flower petal. Similarly, I have also made a Malaysian flower, but I have inserted 1/6 strip of red tight coil in the pendant. Now let's get started with the peacock feather. So for this we will be needing a full strip of deep blue color and make a loose coil. Attach the last end with the coil and then pinch it from between the coil and make a Malaysian flower petal. But we'll also be needing 1/4 strip of light blue color and making a loose coil and just inserting in the middle of the deep blue color like so, and then wrap the two coils using light blue, orange, red and yellow color strip. So I'll be needing 1/4 strip of each of the four colors to surround the Malaysian tight coil. So in this way, the center of the peacock feather is created. Now let's get started with the peacock feathers. So for this we will need half strip of sap green color and 1/6 strip of light green color to make a tight coil, and then using your pencil or quilling tool just push through the hole to make a conical shape figure like so, just slowly and steadily. Now let's attach all the parts of the feathers using liquid glue or Fevicol MR. Now I will take 1/4 strip of yellow color and make a loose coil and then pinch it from middle to make a Malaysian flower petal. Then wrap the loose coil using my pink color strip and then completely surround it with the pink color strip to make a Malaysian flower petal. Similarly, I made purple or lavender teardrop shapes using half strip of purple or lavender strips. Now this tight coil is made with 1/4 strip of yellow and half strips of pink and orange, and then I will surround with some tight coils which are made using 1/4 strip of pink color and half strip of white color. Similarly, I made this swirl using 1/4 strip of yellows and red color strips it's a part of jewelry. So my quilling is done. Now I will do the background, and for this I'll be using my size number 8 watercolor brush and artist watercolor cakes box, and from there I'm using cerulean blue color and some water to give a shading or just sky effect, like so. So for the field I'm using leaf green and sap green and sometimes dark green to give some shade, like so, and also be using ochre, yellow and brown to give shade and uplift the curd from the background because it's invisible till now. So let's enjoy coloring, and in this way I made the curd visible, and I'm just painting some grass using my number 2 brush and sap green and dark green colors, just blending colors like so, and in this way my painting is created. So my beautiful, adorable quilled Krishna or Gopal painting is ready. So I really hope you guys enjoyed and loved as much as I did while creating it. So do not forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the bell icon for latest updates. Do comment your views, doubts and suggestions in the comment section below, and hope to see you in my next one. Till then, take care. Bye bye.